إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, we have Jum'ah, the first Jum'ah of Ramadan. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. We're able to be at the main ibadah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has obligated upon us to be at in a huge congregation in the month of Ramadan. We know that the reward for things in the month of Ramadan is multiplied anyways. And so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us correct our intentions, to make sure that we are here for the right reasons, and to make sure that we are abiding by the rules and regulations of the Jum'ah so that our ibadah, our worship is perfected and accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jal has told us in the Quran the main purpose of the month of Ramadan, and we're going to repeat it again, and we're going to look at one key aspect of that main purpose. So Allah Azza wa Jal says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ That all you who believe, fasting has been made mandatory upon you, just as it was made mandatory upon those before you, so that you may attain taqwa. And we've talked about taqwa before in various different capacities, but I want to look at today, what is it that you get out of being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What is it that taqwa gives you? What do you get from being someone that is defined with this quality of having taqwa? So Allah says, you may attain taqwa in this month of Ramadan, that is why you should fast. The meaning of taqwa, again, you know, and we've said this many times, is to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Essentially, that's what it means. To obey Allah azza wa jal in that which He has told us to do, and to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stay away from that which He has told us to stay away from. This is the essential meaning of what taqwa is. Being obedient or conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, aware that I am being obedient to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jal says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِ That all you who believe, be obedient to Allah. Have taqwa of Allah, حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ As He deserves for you to be obedient to Him. That it is His right for you to obey Him. As it is His right, you should obey Him. And this seems like a huge, huge burden on our shoulders. How can we possibly be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He deserves to be obeyed? Because He deserves to be obeyed 100%. There's no 99.9% when it comes to the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jal deserves to be obeyed 100, 1000, 2000% of our obedience. But how can we possibly give that much obedience to Allah azza wa jal? He makes the burden light for us. And He describes for us what is the right of Allah Azza wa Jal, that you owe Him to obey Him as is His right. He says, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ SubhanAllah, He says, be obedient to Allah as much as you possibly can. And this is Allah Azza wa Jal, His mercy, lightening the burden for us. Knowing that we cannot even 100% be obedient to Him, all He asks from us is, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ Be obedient to Allah. Be aware of Allah as much as you are possibly able to do so. As much as you are physically possible, as much as you are with your health possible, as much as you are financially possible, whatever is your ability to the honest, full use of your ability, be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is all that He asks from us. And we understand from this that the burdens that are placed upon us in terms of obedience to Allah azza wa jal, we should never, ever, ever downplay those obligations. And I meant to say obligations and not burdens. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has obligated us with certain things, and within His religion, within the deen, within the shara of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has given us ease. He has made things easy for us. He has given us exceptions and so on and so forth. And He has shown us how we can really only be obedient to Him as much as we are possibly able to do so. And I want to give some examples of that. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, صلي قائما فإن لم تستطيع فقاعدا فإن لم تستطيع فعلى جنب. That you should pray. When you should pray standing. This is the way the prayer is taught. You have to pray standing. And he says, but فإن لم تستطيع, if you can't, if it's not possible for you to stand, then you can pray sitting. And he says, and if it's not possible for you to pray sitting, then you can pray lying down on your side. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already given us exceptions and created ease for us within the deen that we don't have to resort to leaving off any of his obligations. And Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us about this month, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَسُمْهُ, that whoever amongst you witnesses this month of Ramadan, he has to fast it. Right? And then he says, فَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِّنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ, but whoever is ill, they're not able to fast. Whoever's on a journey, then they have the exception. They can make it up in any other time of the year, a different number of days, right? يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. And he tells us why. Allah wants for you ease, and he does not want for you difficulty, but he wants you to complete the ibadah. وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةِ. You have to complete the number of days. You have to do what you're supposed to do, but he creates the ease in the ibadat, in the our acts of worship, in the obligations that he places upon us. At no point in time should we ever have to get rid of an obligation that Allah Azza wa Jalla has placed over us. We need to learn more, seek knowledge, ask the people of knowledge. What can we do if our situation is too difficult to fulfill this obligation? And we will find that Allah Azza wa Jalla has made for us a way. Dealing with this, brothers and sisters, I do want to talk about what are the effects of being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Azza wa Jalla has told us that this month is here, you fast this month, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you may attain this quality of taqwa, of being more obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what is it that you get out of being obedient to Allah Azza wa Jalla? Is it just that we are obedient to Him and we get nothing in return? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is eternally merciful, exceptionally merciful, and for the mere right that we owe Him, all we owe Him subhanahu wa ta'ala is that we are obedient to Him, and we shouldn't even have to ask for anything back. This is His right as the Creator, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is just His natural right. Just like He says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen means praise belongs to Allah, the master of all that exists. And not because somebody praises Him. The phrase itself, Alhamdulillah, it means whether or not you accept it, whether or not you acknowledge it, whether or not you do it, it doesn't matter. Praise in and of itself belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's therefore worship in and of itself belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obedience in and of itself, whether you acknowledge it, whether you don't, whether you do it or not, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But regardless of that, Allah azza wa jal takes care of His servants, and He is merciful to them, and He has given us return, much returns for our obedience to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I want to share some of these effects of taqwa that Allah azza wa jal has told us about. The number one effect of taqwa is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will correct your affairs, will help you to do more good deeds, will help you to do more better things in your life, and He will forgive you your sins. So the first number one effect of taqwa you're seeing is that to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not mean that one will be sinless. It means that one will make mistakes and fall into sin, and the effect of obedience is that Allah azza wa jalla will forgive your sins and help you to do better deeds and help you to do more good. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُتِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. That Allah Azza wa Jalla says, O you who believe, اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ, be obedient to Allah, وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا, and say right speech. When you speak correct and right speech. يُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ, He will correct you for you your deeds. He will show you, make good for you your deeds. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ, and He will forgive for you your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, then he has attained the best success. He has attained the absolute best success. So the number one effect of being obedient to Allah Azza wa Jal is continuous obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for when we fail to obey Him, that He will forgive us for our sins, that He will pardon us for our mistakes, and He will allow us to be successful because we are on the path of being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another effect of taqwa that we have is a way out of all different types of difficulties that we face. So one of the major things we're getting out of being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now giving us a way to get out of the things that are holding us back or holding us down. And so Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَالِغُ أَمْرِهِ قَدْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدْرًا. But Allah Azza wa Jalla says, and for those who are obedient to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, مَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا, He will prepare for them a way out. And He doesn't say a way out of what? He doesn't say a way out of what specific thing, but He will make for them مَخْرَجًا, an exit. He will make for them a way that they can escape. And this, subhanAllah, leaves it open to every individual person's own issues and their own concerns and their own problems. What is it that's holding us back that we want to find an escape from? What is it that's keeping us, you know, in this little corner that we wish we could run away from? What are the issues or problems that we are facing that we want solved? Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us one of the solutions, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever is obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obedient. And again, the right of our obedience that we owe Him is to be obedient as much as we are physically, mentally, health-wise, financially capable of doing so. For that person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will create a way out. وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. And He will provide for them. He will give them risk, provide for them from where they cannot even imagine. From where they cannot imagine. A lot of times we're caught in a corner and we have a choice between doing something which is halal, which is permissible, but it doesn't seem like the best way to go. And we have a choice of doing something haram, which is impermissible, and it seems like this will actually be more beneficial. But if we stick to that which is permissible, if we stick to the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Himself says, وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. If you're worried about whatever you need to be provided not being given to you, Allah will give it to you, and not only that, He will give it to you from where you can't even imagine it will come from. So it's understandable why we think, how is this going to work? How is me following the right path or the halal way? How is that going to work? Allah told you He's going to provide you from where you cannot even imagine. You'll never be able to imagine where that's going to come from. But you will see once you are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will provide for you and He will make ways from you from really where you cannot even imagine. And we have to understand that this concept doesn't apply to short-term obedience or one-time acts of obedience, or let me experiment with this and see if it works. I'll pray today and see if my problems are solved. If they're not, then I'll go away. That's not how this works. It's a lifestyle of being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla has promised us. أَفَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا أَفَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do people think that they will be left alone because they say we believe and that they will not be tested? Allah Azza wa Jalla has promised us, the minute you start this path of being obedient to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's going to test you. Are you for sure? Are you for real? He's going to put some difficulties in your path. Allah tells the stories in the Quran about how for Bani Israel, on the Sabt, the day of the Sabbath, where they were not supposed to work, right? What does He tell us about the people that would go, that would use the fishermen on that day? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, by Allah's will, purposefully, He made more fish come before them into the rivers on the Saturday, just to test them. Where He told them, you're not going to work on that day, and then He provides for them more fish. A logical mind would say, well, if I want sustenance, if I want risk, this is the day to get it. Why does Allah prohibit us from a day when we can get more risk? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us in these ways, right? Allah Azza wa Jalla tests us in these ways. And this, the spirituality of obedience is to follow that or pass that test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the minute you start going down the line of obedience to Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah Azza wa Jalla will test you. You start praying, you start fasting in Ramadan, you start giving charity and you start giving your zakah, Allah may test you financially and put you in a bad situation. And you think, I just started praying, now I'm financially in a bad situation. And Allah Azza wa Jalla is seeing, are you going to be obedient long term or are you just short term experimenting? Are you going to be obedient regardless, as is my right for you to obey me? Or are you going to be obedient to me conditionally that you only get what you want? And we know that we have to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regardless of our circumstance, and that long-term obedience, that continuously being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is what is going to get us these results. Forgiveness for our sins, allowing us to do more good deeds, and getting a way out of every difficulty. And to get out of a difficulty, that means Allah Azza wa Jalla has to put you in a difficulty. So we have, just being obedient to Allah Azza wa Jalla does not mean you won't face difficulties. But Allah has promised us, you will find a way out of those difficulties. So the test of Allah Azza wa Jalla will come, the difficulties will continue to come, but obedience to Allah Azza wa Jalla will help you in the long term to get out of those difficulties as well. Another benefit of being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a spiritual thing that Allah Azza wa Jalla gives whoever He wants from amongst His slaves. A way to attain it is to be from those who are obedient constantly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا وَيُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. That if you are obedient to Allah, He will grant you a furqan. He will give you a furqan. Furqan is the ability to judge between right and wrong. To be able to feel inside what is the right thing to do, what is the wrong thing to do. And this is conditional. It comes with, when it comes from Allah, it comes with being obedient to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا. If you are obedient to Allah, Allah will give you this ability, furqana, to be able to figure out what is the right thing to do, what is the wrong thing to do. So for the majority of us, we're not expected to be scholars in the faith, right? The books of fiqh, mashallah, are 25, 30 volumes long, right? Even when it comes to simple things like prayer, or you know, how we should spend our money, and how we should treat other people, and so on and so forth. These are discourses upon discourses written in the books of fiqh, in the books of Islamic legal theory, and all this kind of stuff. But Allah Azza wa Jalla understands that this may be too difficult for the majority of the people, so He grants us this quality, inshaAllah. That if you are obedient to Him, He will help you decide what is right and what is wrong by your being obedient to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the verse continues, وَيُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ. He will forgive you your minor sins. وَيَخْفِرْ لَكُمْ. He will forgive you again. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. And Allah is the one who has great favors. Allah is the one who has these great gifts, and He gives them to whoever He wants. And then He's showing us how you can attain these gifts. And the final thing we want to mention, inshaAllah, with regards to what is it that you get out of being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the ability to attain this quality or this wilaya from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. He says, unquestionably, for the allies of Allah, the awliya of Allah, those who have the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there will be no fear concerning them, nor will they grieve. So this is something very special. And we sometimes compartmentalize these people to be those who dress a specific way or are known for a specific thing, the awliya of Allah. Those who are walis, or people who are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jal tells us that yes, this is a special relationship that Allah Azza wa Jal has with certain slaves, that on these people there will be no fear concerning them, nor will they grieve. But who are these people? He says, Alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaqun. Those who believe and then are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He mentions two things. They believe in Him, they have that faith, and then they go beyond just having that faith, which is something all of us need to do. And that is to be obedient to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obeying Him as much as we possibly can. And the scholars used to say, مَنْ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا, تَقِيًّا كَانَ لِلَّهِ وَلِيًّا. That whoever is a believer and obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this is a wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what it takes to attain something that is so close to Allah Azza wa Jal. And it's not something that is beyond our reach. It's not something that is out of our ability to do. We have to have faith and we have to obey Allah. How do we obey Allah? فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ. As much as you individually in your situation, in your condition possibly can, you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will attain inshaAllah with bi'iznillah, by the permission of Allah, this quality of being someone that has the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Someone that is a wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is obedient constantly as much as they can, obedient to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jalla mentions even more qualities of those who are obedient to Him, and how He describes them, and how beautifully He describes them. So He says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ أَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ عِدَّةٍ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And rush to forgiveness from your master, and a garden, Jannah, as wide as the heavens and the earth, prepared for those who have taqwa. So now we know that there are gardens, Jannat, the heavens that Allah Azza wa Jalla has prepared for those who have taqwa. And then He describes them. He says, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Who are these people that are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He gives us their qualities. And this is a checklist that we need to check off to make sure that we are following these qualities. And this is in Surah Al-Imran, verses 130, 132-135. But Allah Azza wa Jalla says that those who spend in the cause of Allah, أَلَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, during ease, when it's easy for them to spend, when they have a lot of money, وَالضَّرَّاءِ, and when they don't have a lot, and they still spend. So those who spend in good times, and those who spend in bad times, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ, who restrain their anger, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, and who forgive the people, they let the people go, they pardon them, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah loves those who are good to other people. And subhanAllah, these qualities are something we should take into real consideration. Those who spend when they have, and those who spend when they don't have, Those who, when they get angry, so Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling us, you can be a righteous person, you can be an obedient person and have rage inside of you. But what makes you a righteous person is that you're able to suppress that rage. You're able to put it down. That's what makes you a righteous person. And beyond that, the people that are making you angry, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, you're able to let them go and forgive them and pardon them. And then he says, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And we know what the word love means. If you have a child and you tell that child, I love you, you know what those words mean. You know what that word, I love you, means. Meaning, I will take care of you. I will protect you. I will make sure you have everything you need. And Allah tells you, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah loves those who go out of their way to do good, who suppress their anger, who spend in His for when they have and when they don't have, and who can forgive people and let them go. Allah loves these people. And subhanAllah, there's nothing more you could want, either in this life or the next, more than the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So think about your relationships, things that are not going well, and things that make you upset and angry, and how you can possibly let that go, and what you will get out of it. You will get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he continues to describe them, and he says, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَمْ يُسِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And those who, when they commit a major sin, or when they commit a minor sin, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they seek forgiveness for their sins. So Allah is telling you again, the Jannah is for the righteous, for those who are obedient. And the quality of those who are obedient, not that they're sinless, but when they commit either a major sin or a minor sin. Meaning you're obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can still make major sins, you can still fall into minor sins. Allah is not telling you you're going to be this sinless weird person, so not weird, but this sinless special person that's not going to commit any types. And we shouldn't have these perception about people. We shouldn't think that people that are righteous because they are sinless. Allah says, no, there are people who, when they commit a major sin or when they commit a minor sin, what do? They seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They ask for His forgiveness. وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ ذُنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And Allah says, and who else is there that's going to forgive your sins besides Allah? Who else is there that's going to do this? So this quality of being obedient and righteous, all of it is hidden. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows who are these people. And then he says, and then they're people who don't persist in those sins while they are aware of that. وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And then he says, أُولَئِكَ جَزَاؤُهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَجَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. For these people that are obedient, and for these people that spend and forgive and can suppress their anger and are seeking forgiveness for when they sin, for these people, Allah says, their reward for them is مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. What is your reward from Allah? Forgiveness. And again, all of these things, what are they telling you? You're bound to make mistakes. If your reward is forgiveness, what are you coming with in terms of deeds? Right? If you answer all the questions right on an exam, your reward is an A. For doing everything right, you get an A. And Allah is telling you, your reward is forgiveness. Meaning what? You did things wrong. Your reward is being forgiven because you tried. Because you tried to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as you possibly could. So this is a reward. To come to Allah Azza wa Jalla as a faulty, sinful, bad person, but trying my best to obey Allah, seeking forgiveness when I made mistakes, my reward is what? What am I going to get? For sure Allah says, مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ, forgiveness from their master, وَجَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. And you will be admitted into these gardens of paradise, beneath which these rivers flow. This garden which Allah talks about in so many other places of the Quran. That same garden, beneath which these rivers will flow. You will be admitted into paradise. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon all of us for our sins. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow all of us to be able to ask forgiveness for our sins. We ask Allah azza wa jalla to allow us, especially in this month of Ramadan, to spend from our wealth. Even if it is difficult for us, especially if it is easy for us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us suppress our rage and our anger. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us forgive and let other people go and let the situations go that are causing problems in our life. The Prophet ﷺ said, أَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي رَبَضِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْمِرَاءَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مُحِقَّةً. I will guarantee a house in the outskirts of Jannah for someone who will give up argumentation, for someone who will give up quarreling, even if they are right. SubhanAllah, nothing more you could want from anybody else in this world if Allah Azza wa Jalla is promising you a house in the outskirts of Jannah. Nothing more you could want. Giving up these quarrels and these grudges that we have with people, letting them go for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And before we finish, inshaAllah, we need to note that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also taught us to make dua for taqwa. Anything that we want to accomplish, We know that it cannot happen without the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Allahumma inni yas'aluka al-huda wa tuqa wa al-afafa wa al-ghina. Oh Allah, I ask you for guidance and taqwa and health and richness and self-sufficiency. So the Prophet ﷺ used to ask for these things to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. And we need to ask Allah azza wa jalla for these things as well, making sure that we're aware that we have to be obedient to Allah as much as we possibly can, making sure that we're trying to be as obedient to Allah as much as we possibly can. And that is all that we can really do in this world. And we ask Allah azza wa jalla to accept from us. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ